And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Zoe Azir. We're going to have an aggro deck here built around some elusives and just going wide and emptying our hand pretty quickly. So we have 12 one drops, lots of one drops in here. You know, we're going to be playing a Zoe deck, of course. Doomkeeper also another great one drop. Spacey Sketcher goes with the Zoe. But then we're going to be playing the Flight. This is a card that you don't always see, but I think this could be really cool for our deck for a few reasons. One, so basically how the Flight usually plays out is, you know, like it'll strike, get shuffled back in, you redraw it, so you have to replay it. You know, so you play this Flight a few times. But that could be pretty good because we want to just be able to summon 10 units for Azir, right? So like if we're playing the Flight and redrawing it and everything, that can be more summons for the Azir. And then whenever you have the level up Azir, when you summon a unit, it gets the +1/+0, and so does Azir. So, you know, whenever you have your leveled up Azir, you play the Flight, it's now a 3-1 elusive. So one mana, 3-1 elusive, pretty good. Well, we can make that even better. We're going to be playing three Inspiring Marshals. So whenever we summon our allies, give it +2/+0 this round. So again, we're playing the Flight and then attacking with it. Now it's going to be a 4-1 with the Marshal. If we have the Azir, a 5-1. Like, those are big elusives for just one mana. So I think that could be pretty cool. Let's see. We're also going to be playing some gem stuff. We're going to have Mentor the Stones, Mountain Goat, creating those gems. Like, Mentor the Stones can buff up these elusives, whether they're going to be Shadestalker or Zoe or, you know, the Invoke cards. We're probably going to be getting, like, the three Invoke elusive quite a bit, too. So those gems will be good cards for Spacey Sketcher to discard as well. Let's see. Since we're going to be being aggressive with our elusives, we're going to have Ruinous Path to be able to help drain our opponent out. We've got a couple combat spells in here with Pale Cascade, Hush, Quicksand. You have some good stuff there. Some protection with Ride Negation and Hourglass. We do have the ability. We're going to play one Hourglass for protection. But we do have the ability, if we have the two Zoes in hand, or you know, like one Zoe in play, we Hourglass it, we can play another Zoe. And then we can have two Zoes in play. So we could be, you know, going double Zoe, which can always be pretty crazy. Yeah, so that's going to be our deck. It should be a pretty good one. This one looks really good. I'm excited about this. So let's go ahead and play some games with Zoe Azir. Those are two of the best champions right now, Zoe and Azir. So combining them together. All right, we got Maokai and Nautilus. They're going to be going deep. But very impressed with the deep deck since the changes and everything. And they usually play hired guns these days. And higher gun's gonna be good against most everything that we got. I think I'm just gonna mulligan everything. Wow. This could not have been a worse hand. Well. This could not have gone any worse. Even Harvey's complaining about how bad our hand is. Greater things await. All right, gotta get these sand soldiers out here. All right, so we have protection from Jaw Hunters with the quicksands. Two Withering Whales gone. That's probably good for me to see, considering like the Withering Whales would just take down my Sand Soldiers very easily.
I will tend this garden.
Mystical levitation requires concentration. Oh, floating crystals.
And of course we want to attack before. Before they play something, get a sapling that gets a free block. Kind of want to just play the quicksand just so I can turn on Nightfall for the Pale Cascade to like Pale Cascade and try to draw a card. That's probably not like the best idea. I don't know, my hand's pretty bad. We're not gonna, yeah, so like Ruinous Path won't be enabled.
We have an empire to build.
I guess I just let it happen. Hey, Fly Rocket. Okay, three Withering Whales have been tossed.
My name echoes through every rock, every canyon.
So the Pill Cascade healed the Azir. Don't need to throw out Mountain Goat or mention the stones in front of a sapling. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I got 9 in hand. Double check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes, okay.
Gems are superb. Bad for the teeth, though.
Mother Moon, veil me.
I mean, Ruination is an option, I guess. Quicksand does not help against Devour because it only checks the health. So if they play like a Withering Whale or something, it does not help. I meant Vile Fuse. I was thinking Vile Fuse whenever I said that, but. Alright, so that levels up Azir. So now our three Sand Soldiers that we'll make with attacking will all be, larger.
Greater things await!
I kind of don't think I attack with Mentor the Stones. I don't really want to put three gems in my hand, do I? What deck are you using, Riven? Close to five, Caretaker. So whenever you disable keywords, this is deep is a keyword. So it will get rid of the +3/+3 that these sea monsters have. I don't know if that will really affect anything, but that is a thing. Sure it matters, but it's a thing. Yeah, hushing. So it doesn't have the attack enemies get the -2/-0. Oh, that's awesome, Caretaker. Good job. Huge win streak in ranked with Vladimir Braum. Cool. I guess I can just take it. Yeah, let's just take it. A Spacey Sketcher would be nice. Or a Zoe. Ooh, what's up, Zoe?
Look how sparkly.
Now, this is just an opportunity for me to play that Ruinous Path. Because Quicksand, okay, so while Quicksand would have got rid of the -3/-3, it's still, like, Devour is still, like, normally 4 health, so it would have only turned Devour into 4 health, so I could not have killed Devour unless, I guess I could have maybe blocked with my Azir. I wasn't really thinking about blocking with the Azir, but.
Nope. Destiny calls.
Okay, Azir's a 7/7. Do I want to keep two quicksands up or not? Kind of thinking they maybe have, like, Vengeance on the Zoe. They could have Atrocity, though. Maybe two quicksands help out against an Atrocity. All three Withering Wails are gone. We've seen two Vile Feast gone? Maybe one?
I cannot be broken.
Alright, was Vengeance. That was the fear. Yep, that's how my opponent stayed alive. I was hoping it was just Atrocity, right? Because Atrocity, I had the two Vengeance to protect from. The two Quicksand. I had the two Quicksands to protect, but Vengeance I could not protect. That was kind of like the only card that they played that would have saved them. Because all their Withering Wails were gone. We open attacked, so they couldn't Ruination. Yeah, unfortunately they had the only card that saved them. So that means that that would be my... So I have four cards, we'd play the Messenger, we have three, we go to their turn, we draw, we have two, we go to our turn, we draw, we have one, so we'd have... So we still wouldn't die yet, so let's get this Messenger. Because we need some more cards.
And so life springs anew.
Put me down to zero? Because yeah, next turn is our only turn to try to kill them. I don't know if we'll have a good chance.
Hold still.
That doesn't work? Okay, well, I guess he learns something new every day. It still has Fearsome. Even through Quicksand, it doesn't get rid of the keyword. How about that? Well, we're not dead at least. Not yet. Yeah, that was unexpected. Yeah, so I guess that's an aura. This sea monster allies have Fearsome is just it doesn't have the keyword Fearsome. It has like this aura that just says that all your sea monster allies have Fearsome. We still need to do the Quicksand to stay alive. And looks like they are debating whether or not to cast Atrocity. So we haven't seen them really toss any Atrocities, I don't think. The flight, the final flight And there's the atrocity that they were waiting to see if they could play or not. So unfortunately, they had the Vengeance. They had the one card that kept them alive in their whole deck. We return to the sands for now. That's too bad. Yeah, because our opening hand was so bad. Imagine if we just had, you know, like one Doomkeeper in the opening hand even. Like, I could have just played a turn one Doomkeeper. That would have been 4 damage. And that could have been like that extra 4 damage we needed. So still good sign being so close with such a bad hand, I think. I like this hand. I could see mulliganing the Ruinous Path. That's probably like the one that I shouldn't be keeping. But I like the other three. I probably should be mulliganing Ruinous Path, but I've always liked that card. I'm worried about them playing 3-2 Challenger. Alright, cool.
Bask in her radiant blessing.
Well, I can't attack because if I attack, my flight goes away, and then it allows them to attack with the Zoe, right? I can't make that attack.
Men die, but Shurima lives forever.
I can now make that attack. Now that I have backup Zoe.
Remember this day.
Back, heretic.
I got Zoe and Shadestalker. I got the Quicksand.
Daylight warms the heart and lights the way.
Zoe. Alright, so we're at 6 for Azir. I should have mulliganed this Ruinous Path to begin with. That was an incorrect move by me. Screeching Dragon, pretty good. Not letting me turn on Ruinous Path. Alright, so we'll go. Another Zoe. We should probably play that Zoe after they attack. But if I play it before, right now they're going to be challenging and killing this Shadestalker. Whoa, theirs is only at 2? They've only played Solari Priestess and Screeching Dragon? Yeah, they're gonna have awesome. Yeah, that's true. They have awesome celestial cards. This is gonna be a tough one to finish out the game. Screeching Dragon is such a great card. This card gives me a lot of. Makes it really difficult to win. We just need to cycle these.
Thank you.
Yeah, there is Meteor Shower.
And here's where I paint my
Messenger to draw cards. They have a few more cards in here than I do.
Shurima, your emperor has returned.
Yeah, it won't be easy.
Greater things await!
Might be easy to win this game. Taking risky lines, because we kind of need to.
Back, heretic. Believe or burn.
Wish I would have mulliganed that ruinous bat to start with. That screeching dragon did too much.
Zoe, I'm a serious artist now. I paint sparkle flights.
I am more myself than ever.
All right, good game, opponent. Alright, Lissandra Trundle. They do a good job of killing small things. That's probably bad for us. Let's get rid of the Dune Keeper. Okay, cool. Mentor can buff something up. I'm sorry. I didn't catch it.
A true Freljordian welcome.
So it's not a trade I want to make because of Ice Shard.
I will bury the world in ice.
Gems are superb. Bad for the teeth, though.
See what we see. So.
The Mentor of the Stone's flight is always just kind of a little awkward. Alright, which one do I save? Let's say save. Mentor. Our go wide with a bunch of small things strategy may not be the best here. But we're going to try it out. Alright, so maybe I go... Should I just go Azir Shadestalker? Yeah, let's just do that.
Shurima, your emperor has returned.
So that's 6, this is 7. If I play Dune Keeper,
I
think we just gotta be real aggressive.
Emperor, I am honored.
Not bad. Alright, so they're not making the Watcher yet. Neighbor just started mowing. All right, so we're attacking for 6, putting down to 11. Yeah, we could use a gem. Why not? Let's make it 7. That extra point of damage can matter. Inspiring Marshall, I forgot we had that one in our deck.
Secrets hidden by frost.
The Emperor's favor upon you.
Does mean that I want to play other stuff before attacking again. I don't want to just, you know, open attack with having Inspiring Marshall. They should know that I have the flight, so I'll just lead with that one, because that's not really that's a pretty obvious one that I'm gonna have. Man, so if their plan's Ice Shard, I'm going for it. Withering Whale is just, you know, a worse Ice Shard. Hope it's not that either.
You can see the Devastian border from here.
With Azir's blessings!
Sand and blood!
Like this.
Mm-hmm. Ready the torches. Look out for Reavers.
Feels like Withering Whale or Ice Shard.
Foolish child.
Ugh. The worst. This is tough. This is tough to beat a deck that, you know, Ice Shard kill all your stuff, now Ruination, and then Withering Whale, Vile Feast. Like, this is not easy. It was close. It was close.
I bear a message from... Oh, hey, what's that?
So I have to block with the 4-3.
For the homestead!
You seek an audience?
Sunlight!
Shurima is sand and sky, past and present. You need not follow, but you
so
will.
We still have 3 cards in hand. Our draw is going to have to be really good. Not it.
It is fine. Ready the torches.
So get the 8/8 overwhelm next turn. It's like our deck's coming close, but we're lacking the late game power. The board's too soft and quiet. So we're gonna switch up the boards. That's what I think we needed to do. Okay, this one's gone. We have the attack token turn 2. Alright, we going all out. We're going all out with the turn 2 attack.
See what greasy sword. The Emperor commands, the land obeys.
Let's go. Big flex. We're going all out. We don't have any cards left. But attack for 11. There we go! See, we just needed to switch the board up. Got there. Turn two, kill. Shadow Isle Shurima. Alright. Aggro Mirror. So let's see. I go turn one, the flight. Turn two, Doomkeeper. Turn three, Azir. Turn four, I'm like playing flight plus Shadestalker. Like I said, turn one, Zoe. Because we won't play the Zoe first to get to the 10 cards. For leveling up Zoe, which is unlikely, but possible. Maybe not probable.
See what we see.
Aggro. Dude, we just need to change the board. Just need to change the board. Alright, good hit for 5. And deal a damage to their 2-drop. Risen Mist. I'll just take it.
Shurima, your emperor has returned.
I could have Quicksand block and killed their thing. Alright, come on. 0-2-1. Yes. Where are we at? We're at 6. Seven. Eight. Nine. Turn 4, level Azir.
Greater things await.
Is it worth attacking with the 2-6 Azir? They block with the 4-3. Maybe not.
Arise, I have risen and weakened Shurima.
Our deck can be pretty cool. We need to change the board. Now we got this luck. These are better hands for sure. Alright, another 5 damage in.
In Shurima's name.
So we take 7, go to 8. Ooh. +2/+2 ephemeral. So do I want Azir to take 2 damage? I could just... So we can go with the Hourglass. Or I could just, you know, save the mana for Super Cool Star Chart. I guess we just go with the Hourglass. Where are you at? You're at 7. So this is going to be 8. I can't play Trickster and Flight. I can go Messenger, Flight, but Messenger doesn't really matter. I guess I just go... I don't really need Hush. I guess we just play Trickster and Flight. So that's 10. Now we get Elusive Azir. Attack. All right, there we go. That was pretty sweet. All right, we had some cool last two games, and Azir finally gets to fly like he always wanted. All right, so those last two games were awesome. That's what our deck's about. It's about like being real aggressive with 12-1 drops, you know, getting elusives, you know, even leveling up the Zoe, having the Azir, put in a bunch of Sand Soldiers. You know, we got to level up Azir on turn four, level with our turn four attack, we leveled Azir. Then turn six, level Zoe, everything elusive. That was pretty cool. With some interaction in between. That's what our deck's about. Those last two games, like where we just put a whole bunch of bodies in play right away. The first couple of games, especially that first game, we just had a really bad hand. But yeah, we had some slow hands those first few games, and we came close. We were close to winning like game one, game three, but our hands were a little too slow. Game two, not so much. We just got Screeching Dragoned. They had turn one Zoe to kind of stop us, of like stop our elusives. So there we go. That was Zoe Azir. So can be a fast aggro deck. He liked to, you know, play a whole bunch of stuff super fast. We got some, you know, elusives, buffing those up, all that kind of stuff. Cool little deck. All right, so those of y'all watching later on YouTube, hit that like button over there. And as always, feel free to leave those comments. What do you think for like the top end of this? Like, is there a better like finisher maybe than Inspiring Marshal? You know, we were thinking about like that with the flight and stuff like that. But maybe we just need something else. Maybe this should just be Ruin Runner instead of, and just play zero Marshal, three Ruin Runner for overwhelmed help finish games. Because that's what we notice against the decks that are better at defense. It was kind of a little difficult for us to finish games. We didn't have that top end power. Ruinous Path didn't really do enough because we have just so many small units that just kind of die that we don't necessarily slay units. So maybe a better like 4 or 5 drop, maybe, I don't know, Sand Spinner, you know, whatever else there, 4 or 5, some Crystal Ibex, Bone Crusher, not that card, but you know, maybe Sand Spinner, I don't know, something else. Maybe instead of Ruinous Path Marshal, some other way to finish out games. All right, but anyway, that's it here for Zoe Azir. So thank you. So leave those comments. Let me know what you think for the top end. What should we do? But besides that, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.